Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of Morning English. I am Joseph.
大家好，我是卡拉。今天让九老师来开场啊。好，我们今天呢要和大家来分享这个发音的话题啦。
Right, we're going to share with you some English words that you're probably mispronouncing.
Mispronounce 就是发错音，因为 miss 是一个比较常见的这个否定前缀。
We know that the English pronunciation is probably one of the biggest frustrations that all English learners have right now. And these words we've chosen are difficult because of the combination of letters or sounds. And your eyes can, in fact, play tricks on you because the letters that you see, they don't sound like you think they should.
对，还有一个呢，其实也强调很多次了，就好像 there's not just one Chinese accent, the English accent changes from city to city and town to town. 就可能有的词呢，各个地方的发音也会略有不同，这个如果碰上了的话，就不要觉得太奇怪。比如说 ask 这个词， some Americans would pronounce it as X, really?
I guess so, maybe if you don't have a very good educational background, but...We all know that it's ask and not axe. Axe is what you use to cut down a tree.
就是会有一些的这个美国人会把这个词发成 axe. 当然，据九老师说，可能是一些文化程度、受教育程度不是那么高的美国人。那其实我觉得这个词的三单其实也还挺难念的，叫 asks, asks 就很绕。OK, 那我们就不再多说了啊，来看看是哪些词你曾经都发对了吗
？Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
首先，第一个词，图书馆，让九老师来给出正确的示范。
Library。
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 Library。这个词呢，我们之前就讨论过，要么就是天音节，要么就是少音节。像以前我的初中英文老师就经常教我们，就老是教我们读 library。其实这样就是添了音节在里面。
Right, and some Americans I've heard mispronounce it before as library, like strawberry or blueberry. Yeah, it's a library.
尤其在读快的时候非常容易发生这个样子，这样其实就是少了音节。所以 again, 正确的读法应该是
library.
Okay, the second word is 蔬菜，正确的读法应该是 vegetable.
I guess this word could be challenging because there's four syllables when you look at it, but when we pronounce it, we say it much quicker, so it just sounds like vegetable instead of vegetable.
这个难点呢就在于你一眼看上去啊会觉得它有四个音节 syllable 就是音节的意思 but there's not. There are only three syllables.
Right, the middle part when the vegIt just disappears, so vegetable.
Vegetable.、大家可以一边听的时候呢，一边跟着念一念 vegetable, 蔬菜 I'm going to the market to get some vegetables for dinner.
Next, we have comfortable, 舒服的。
哦，中文很棒哦。
This word, just like vegetable or even family,has an extra vowel in it when you read it, but it doesn't get pronounced.
看到这个 or, 也就是 or, 大家可能会觉得要发一个 or 的音，比如说 pork, 猪肉，或者觉得可能得发一个 er, 比如说 work. 但其实呢，在这个单词里面它是不发音的。Joseph 说的这个 extra vowel 就是一个额外的多余的元音，所以 it's not comfortable or comfortable, but...
Or not even comfortable. Yeah, comfortable.
Comfortable.
You can skip the sound after the F and just go straight into the tubble sound. Comfortable. These shoes are not very comfortable.
好，下一个词叫做三文鱼，它的英文呢，先给大家来拼写一下 S-A-L-M-O-N. 但是呢，它不读 salmon, 而读成 salmon.就是这个 L is silent.
Exactly. Salmon. not salmon,、
嗯、
salmon. I ordered a fine fillet of salmon.
其实像这种含有不发音的 L 的词还有好一些。There are lots of other English words that have a silent letter L in them. Words like...
Half, H-A-L-F, half, or calf, C-A-L-F.Calf
就是 小腿是吧、
嗯、
然后还有一些还有一些词比如说 wood 或者 talk 像这些词呢如果说你发音发得特别快的时候啊这个 L 的音会被弱化掉但是这个音其实还是在的只不过你念得比较快会听起来像没有似的 wood talk 下一个词珠宝首饰我觉得这个单词对我来说还挺难发的所以 Joseph 你来
Jewelry.
Jewelry.
One more time. Jewelry.
Jewelry.
There we go.
其实这个词呢 it's spelled differently in American English and British English.
Right. Americans spell it J-E-W-E-L-R-Y, jewelry. And I think that's the way to help you remember how to spell it or pronounce it. Jewel, J-E-W-L-Y, re, R-Y.Jewelry.
对其实美式这个拼写方式的话就和发音一一对应了但是呢英式会拼写成 J-E-W-E-L-L-E-R-Y 在这种情况下呢看起来就好像有一个 extra vowel that you don't need to pronounce 就很容易犯错很多人会读成 jewelry 这个就是错的了
Right, it's depending on what kind of accent I guess you want to say. If you want to say it with an American accent, jewelry, two syllables, and spelled J-E-W-E-L-R-Y. And if you want to use the British spelling and pronunciation, then now you have three syllables. Jewelry, J-E-W-E-L-L-E-R-Y, jewelry.
OK, 到最后一个单词 The last one is especially difficult
So easy
哎衣服衣物这个词叫做 clothes
Right, clothes It sounds like the opposite of open Close, please close the door I bought some new clothes
这个词呢要给大家重点解释一下就是很多同学会把这个词读成 clothes clothes 之类的但是呢它其实是 th 发了一个浊辅音 z 然后呢后面的 es 是一个 plural form 所以它就读一个 z 连起来就是 clothes 但是呢它在读得特别快的时候就是我们日常交流的时候啊你直接把它发成 clothes 就好了
Right, and this noun is always plural, so it would be what you guys call uncountable. You always should have some kind of measure in front of it. So you say, you know, an article of clothes.
但是呢，和这个类似，其实发音不一样的，非常常见的一个东西是什么呢？就是轻辅音 th, 然后再加上一个复数轻辅音的 s. 这种比如说，那个 the smiths,The Smiths, 那我们平时说的时候呢就要把两个音都发出来 Right?
Right, or maybe the word months
对就是那个月份然后加上 S 复数这两个音都要发出来 Months, months 它们的难点呢就在于说你要先咬住舌尖然后再迅速把舌尖放开发下一个辅音
Right, the TH is very soft and it reminds me of my favorite word for a Chinese person to say Can I hear you say twelfths?
Twelfths
There you go.
对这个咬舌音呢会被弱化一点但是你不能直接把它省略掉不念。
Okay, so these are some of the words that I've constantly hear Chinese students mispronounce. And I hope this podcast will help you guys out there, you know, speak more correctly and improve your English greatly.
希望大家听完这期节目之后呢能够准确地掌握这些错误频率非常高的单词的发音
Hello, welcome to Morning English 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道每天都会更新如果你想获得关于英语 听说读写的内容我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语，如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频了。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
So thanks for listening, and again, this is Kara.
And I'm Joseph. We'll see you next time.
Bye-bye.